hang on to what I'm about to show you, because this is major. This is about changing the way you mix beats or mix music forever. Only thing you need here is a DAW, and it doesn't matter which one. It could be GarageBand, it could be Cubase, Pro Tools, FL Studio, Ableton, Reason, Bitwig, and so on and so forth. And in this part, we're making a template from scratch, and that's really not that complicated if you just follow the principles. So let's open a new project, empty project, and create. And this goes for any DAW and all versions of Logic Pro. What I do when I start to make a template is I start with the tracks. So I'll just figure out ballpark how many tracks do I use in a typical mix. So say you're a beat maker, you have drums, bass, samples or instruments or synths, maybe some transitional effects, the voice tag, of course, maybe, and that's pretty much it. But if you're more of a holistic type of music maker that you like to have also the option of vocals, for example, you will include vocals as well. So I'll start with 60 tracks. Now that sounds a lot, but then I will start to think, how is a track constructed? What does a song consist of? Well, so we'll always start with the drums for whatever reason. Now let's say kick. I never find myself using more than 3. The next thing is snare 1, snare 2, and snare 3. And you can have hi-hat slow, hi-hat fast, hi-hat open, some perks. Maybe you will have some tambourines, right? You might want to have it. And then you have cymbals, bongos. Who doesn't love a good bongo? Let's find a color for the drums. Select everything and hit option C. I don't know, purple. Is that good? Purple. Maybe a darker purple like that. Okay, not so glaring, glossy. Okay, next up, bass. And there are typically two types of basses, and when I produce at least. So you have the bass, the regular, and then you have the sub. The regular is more for texture, and the other is for the sub frequencies. So you need both, and many times both the sub and the texture is in one sample. For example, if you've sampled a bass guitar, for example, you have all the frequencies in there. You can always choose to split them up and treat them separately. Option C, the bass should be red at all times, at all costs. Red. Okay. Next up comes the instrument section. And what I typically do, I have something that I call the main loop. I have almost never mixed a song that hasn't an element that couldn't be called the main loop. So that's been a mainstay. And then I have alt loop. So then you have alt loop 2, and then maybe another one, alt loop 3. Then you can start imagining all the other things that you typically would put on top of that again. Some stabs, piano, some strings, maybe some, what's it called again? In Norwegian we say blåsere, and in English that's blowers, and then you have some synths, and maybe you have synth 2, effects, transitional effects, maybe you have 2, 1, and 2. These can be used for vocals, for example. Now what we'll do, we'll sort them. So we can go into the mixer channel by hitting X, and you see all the drums have one color, right? And we will route all those drums into a separate bus. Let's just call that bus 1. Bus 1. We call those drums. Okay, that's everything drums. Additionally, we can put them in a folder, select, hit create track stack, this is in Logic, and just a folder stack. Not a summing stack, but a folder stack, like that. Now let's rename this one and call it beat. Let's root all things beat into that folder. That's folder 7. Okay, and then we can root all the background vocals and the lead vocals into a new bus. Let's call though that bus vocals. A lot of stuff going on here. I'll select everything, right click or option click, create track. And now I can sort them in the correct order. Now we're almost done. Let's just select these two, route them into bus 8, which will be the mix bus. And let's, for the sake of it, route the mix bus into a master out. And we'll make tracks out of these as well, right here. So we have the mix bus and the master. Now, the only thing that we're lacking now is the send effects, and that's a bit more tedious. And luckily, we only have to do this once. Let's suppose that I want to have a snare verb, and I will send it to a bus. Now, let's start a bit down here. So I'll start with bus 15, just to keep it a bit separated. I will call this snare verb. And this is now routed to stereo out. I don't want that. I want to route it to another bus that I can call the effects bus. Let's see, here it is, effects bus, or I can just call it effects. And I want to route effects into maybe the mix bus. Argued with myself, I've discussed it a lot with myself in the past years, should there be separate vocal effects and separate beat effects? I don't have a clear answer. Let me know in the comments what you think. But I think this is a way to go. Right click, create track. I have it right here. I'll drag it down to the bottom. And I'll let it reside after the background vocals, just before the beat. Okay, now we have all the buses. Right click, create track stack, folder stack, and let's just call them. In Logic, you go save as template, file, save as template. And then you can save it like, I can call it test template for now. Now, if you want more videos like this, check out one of these where I really smash it with the beat making and with the mixing. So don't hesitate. I hope I see you there. Thanks so much for watching. Peace out.